A home is the ultimate evidence that here in America, hard work pays off, that responsibility is rewarded. Our housing market is beginning to heal. Home prices are rising at the fastest pace in 7 years. Sales are up nearly 50%. Millions of families have been able to come up for air. They're no longer underwater on their mortgages. We've got to build on this progress. We're not where we need to be yet. And there are some immediate actions we could take right now that would help on that front, that would make a difference. So let me just list a couple of them. Number one, Congress should pass a good bipartisan idea to allow every homeowner the chance to save thousands of dollars a year by refinancing their mortgage at today's rates. We need to get that done. We've been talking about it for a year and a half, 2 years, 3 years. There's no reason not to do it. Now that we've made it harder for reckless buyers to buy homes that they can't afford, let's make it a little bit easier for qualified buyers to buy the homes that they can afford. And step three is something that you don't always hear about when it comes to the housing market. And that is fixing our broken immigration system. It would actually help our housing market. It's pretty simple. When more people buy homes and play by the rules, home values go up for everybody. Let's invest in affordable rental housing. Let's bring together cities and states to address local barriers that drive up rents for working families. It gives more options to families who aren't yet ready to buy. All that's going to improve the housing market and will improve the economy. But, and this is the last key point I want to make, as home prices rise, we can't just reinflate another housing bubble. One of the key things to make sure it doesn't happen again is to wind down these companies that are not really government, but not really private sector. They're known as Freddie Mac and Fannie Mae. Private capital should take a bigger role in the mortgage market. I know that sounds confusing to folks who call me a socialist. I think I saw some posters there on the way in. I believe that our housing system should operate where there's a limited government role, and private lending should be the backbone of the housing market. And that includes, by the way, community-based lenders who view their borrowers not just as a number, but as a neighbor. Third principle is we should preserve access to safe and simple mortgage products like the 30-year fixed-rate mortgage. That's something families should be able to rely on when they're making the most important purchase of their lives. Families who are working to climb their way in the middle class, we've got to do what we can to make housing affordable. And that means we've got to strengthen the FHA so it gives today's families the same kind of chance it gave my grandparents to buy a home, and it preserves those rungs on the ladder of opportunity. We can do all this if we work together. And it won't be easy, but if we take just a few bold steps and if Washington will just end the gridlock, set aside the slash and burn partisanship, actually try to solve problems instead of scoring political points, our economy will grow stronger a year from now, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, and as long as I've got the privilege to serve as your president, that's what I'm going to be fighting for.